Today on the newscast, Israeli archaeologists have found a 3,100-year-old inscription that they believe may refer to the biblical judge Gideon. Get all the breaking details coming up. Hey folks, Erick Stakelbeck here. Welcome to the Watchman Newscast. Some breaking archaeological news just announced yesterday, July 12th, yet another amazing discovery in Israel. A 3,100-year-old inscription from the time of the Book of Judges that may refer to the biblical judge Gideon. Now this comes on the heels of last week's big announcement of a 2,000-year-old public building in Jerusalem from the time of Jesus that was recently uncovered. You can check that out here in our archives. It was the July 9th newscast. But today, we are focusing on this incredible Old Testament find from the time of Gideon. Our good friend, Danny the Digger Herman, tour guide, archaeologist, and Watchman Show contributor, joined us from his home in Israel with the inside story. Take a look. Danny the Digger Herman, thanks so much for joining us as always, my friend. Hey, an amazing archaeological discovery, yet another to talk about in Israel. This one dates back to the Book of Judges about 3,100 years ago. Danny, tell us about what the Israeli archaeologists found.
Yes, I was really fascinated to read about this, and I immediately opened to check out what it's all about. And wow, the picture was showing a pottery shard with the name Yerubal, the other name of one of the leaders of the Israelites in the Book of Judges, Gideon. Gideon's other name was Yerubal. And what really amazed me is that the type of the letters, you know, it's called paleography, dating by the shape of the letters, the style of the letters fits the time of the Book of Judges. And it is also found in a site that relates to the time of the Book of Judges. Okay, so we always get excited when we make discoveries relating to the time of King Hezekiah or the Sennacherib campaign against Judea. But here is something that predates it by about 300 years, and it matches in time, in style, and with a figure known from the Bible, from the Book of Judges. You know what? Thinking about it, I think it's the first time ever that archaeology produced an archaeological discovery of a name known from the Book of Judges.
Yeah, and Gideon, Danny, what a name, as you said, a sword for the Lord and for Gideon. I think of that famous rallying cry. Number one, this is a rare discovery from that Book of Judges period, Danny, as you said. But secondly, tell us more about the discovery itself, if you can. Was this a pottery shard? Where was this inscription bearing what may have been the biblical name of Gideon, or a nickname, I guess you would say? Where was it found?
It was found in a site whose Arabic name is Khirbet Erai. It's not too far from Lachish, which we have filmed there. It's actually halfway between Lachish and Gat, the Judean town and the Philistine town. And the archaeologists that are working there, Yossi Garfinkel from the Hebrew University and others, have argued that this site might be the famed site whose location is still not clearly known, the site of Tziklag. We know that when David was battling against Saul over the kingship, at some point he goes to the king of Gat, the Philistine city, and the king of Gat gives him the site of Tziklag. So the site has to be not too far from Gat, but it still has to be in Judea. We know that from Tziklag, he went and raided against the Amalekites. And to this day, they haven't proven where that site is. So Khirbet Erai is this candidate that has been excavated for the last, I don't know, 3 or 4 years. And in this last season, they find a clear layer from the time of the transition from the Philistines to the early Israelites, which is the Book of Judges, the earlier part of it. And within it, they find a name of a charismatic leader from the time of the Book of Judges, Gideon, whose other name was Yerubal. I mean, this is such an amazing combination, such a rare event. And especially writing material from this period is so, so rare to discover, because writing just began at that period. We have a lot of literacy in the 8th century, in the 7th century, but very, very rarely do we make a discovery that goes back to the 10th and 11th century. And now we even have a name of one of the charismatic leader, what's called a judge, a shofet, The fifth shofet from the book of Judges, Gideon, the one who battled successfully against the Midianites, you know?
Yes, and what a story. And Gideon was so hesitant at first, Danny. He put his fleece out looking for direction and the okay from God, and he got it, obviously, and became a mighty man of God. And one of the judges, as you said, it's a legendary story in the Old Testament. Yeah. Hey, last question. These finds are coming so fast, and you and I have discussed this a lot. It's hard to keep track. What does this say to you? I mean, as someone who does this, you live and breathe this stuff. You must be very excited to see all of this unfolding at such a rapid clip. Our friends at the Israel Antiquities Authority seem to be making these announcements practically every week now about some stunning new archaeological discovery.
Yes, we both subscribe to the announcements of Yoli Schwartz, the spokesman of the Israel Antiquities Authority, and it just keeps coming.
Yeah.
And it's a big blessing. Even with the pandemic, the research continues. And the magic of this field is not finding another layer and another wall or another floor, but finding another piece of evidence that can fit the biblical narrative. That's magic. When this source that is so ancient, recording events of 3,000 years ago, can actually be validated in various degrees to finds that come out of the ground. Erick, that's amazing. There is like a divine providence behind this. And as someone that deals with this professionally and now also on a business level as a tour guide, I'm so excited to bring people and show to them again and again how the Bible is living. The Bible is alive. The Bible has proof from the ground.
Yeah, and you and I just did it a few weeks ago, Danny. I was in Israel with you. We were reunited. It had been a while because of COVID, obviously, yes. But we encourage everyone to get to Israel and hook up with our good friend, Danny the Digger. You see the information there, DannyTheDigger.com. And just a quick tease for everyone, some upcoming Watchman material. You and I did some very good stuff in the Western Wall Tunnels, on top of the Temple Mount, some Ark of the Covenant material, some really good stuff coming up with our good friend, Danny the Digger, on the Watchman show and right here on the newscast.
And I must also add that Israel is also getting over the pandemic, and August 1st, tourists will be permitted to enter the state. Finally, after nearly a year and a half, the tourism is going to be finally revived. I mean, we had a few small groups coming till now, but independent travelers will be permitted from August 1st.
Danny, that is great news. You will be a very busy man, and that's great to hear. Thanks, as always, for joining us here on The Watchman. We will see you again soon. Thanks, Danny.
Thank you, Erick. Litot. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thanks to Danny, and very special thanks, as always, to Yoli Schwartz and the entire team at the Israel Antiquities Authority for providing great photos and info on this incredible new find. Hey, two quick things before we go. Remember, this Thursday, July 15th, we are having a Watchman live stream event right here on our YouTube channel. Be sure to join us from 4 to 5 p.m. Eastern Time, live, and bring your questions because we'll have a Middle East Q&A. Also, our good friends at Arca have a new subscription box available. This one features top-notch products made in Israel by Israeli companies from the Galilee region. Folks, I don't endorse many products here on The Watchman, as you may have noticed, so when I do partner with someone, you know that I believe in their mission. Not only does Archa produce a great product that brings the Holy Land to your doorstep, but you are also blessing Israeli small businesses and in the process fulfilling the biblical mandate laid out in Genesis 12:3. Go to archabox.com and use the discount code WATCHMAN18 to get an 18% discount off your Arca Box subscription. We think you'll enjoy it. Thanks so much for joining us here today on the Watchman Newscast. Until tomorrow, God bless you. And remember, never hold your peace. Hey everyone, thanks for checking out the Watchman Newscast. If you enjoyed this episode and want to see more, make sure you go ahead and hit the like button, click subscribe, and tap the bell icon to turn on notifications for new Watchman Newscast episodes every weekday.